Now today in this session of class 11 accountancy, we will be going to discuss about some of the source documents. What do you mean by source documents? Or let's say documents. Documents are the evidence of any transaction. So whenever the business transactions are taking place, there are certain documents through which it can be proved that a particular type of event or a business transaction has been done between the two parties. So these are the documents which helps us in recording the books of accounts, and when there are the source document, we can easily identify the accounts to be debited or to be credited and the amount which is to be debited or to be credited. So documents are the evidence of any business transaction. So whenever there are various types of documents through which we can prove this thing that a particular business transaction has taken place, so that becomes a source document for any business. So today we will be discussing few of the source documents. Cash memo, it is that document in which we get the information that a certain amount of goods has been sold by the seller in cash. This is the document which is prepared at the time of the cash sale, which records the details related with the goods sold, the quantity of those goods, then the rate per piece or per item, total amount to be received, then discount which is to be allowed, everything. All things are being properly mentioned in that document. Okay, so it is prepared by the seller when the goods are being sold in cash. So that is known as cash memo. Then comes invoice or a bill. Invoice or a bill, it is again prepared by the seller, but in this case it is prepared when the goods are being sold on credit. So when the goods are being sold on credit, the document which is prepared, that is known as invoice. The same thing, the name of the party to whom you are selling the goods, the type of goods what have been sold by you, the quantity of goods which is being sold by you, the rate per piece of that particular goods, total amount which you will be taking from that party, and the discount or cash discount, rate discount, whatever you are allowing, each and everything is mentioned there in that bill also. So that invoice is a documentary evidence that a business transaction has taken place in credit. Okay. Then come receipt. Receipt is another source document. When we are receiving any money from the customer, okay, so we are providing a receipt to that customer that a certain amount of money has been received from a customer, which will be prepared in duplicate, and one original copy will be given to the customer and the second copy will be prepared or kept by the drawer himself who is preparing that receipt. He will sign the receipt. He will mention the name of the party from whom the amount has been received and how much amount has been received. And finally, the signature of the authorized person who is accepting that money. So, this is known as receipt, which acknowledges this thing that you have received a certain amount of money from the customer. Paying slip, it is that source document which is evidencing that a certain amount of money has been deposited in the bank either in cash or through check. So whenever we are depositing the money in bank, so there is a particular slip which we have to fill, and that slip is being given to us by the bankers. So bankers have prepared that slip in which all the details are being mentioned, that what is the account number of the person, the date on which you are depositing the money, okay, and how much money is being deposited by you, the denomination of the currency notes, that how many notes are of 2000 rupees, how many notes are of 500 rupees if you are depositing the money in cash. And then we will be writing both the amount, that is in words or in figures, and then it is signed by the person who is depositing that money. So it has got two parts. So one counterfoil is being given to the depositor as an evidence that he has deposited the money and it is signed by the cashier, and the another part is being kept by the cashier. Nowadays in bank there is a drop box in which we can drop the check also. So we have to fill that slip and we just tie up the check with that slip and just drop in the box. So at that point of time we are not receiving the counterfoil signed by the cashier. We are not receiving that thing. So we will receive that counterfoil after a time period or whenever we go to the bank next time. Okay. So this is a paying slip. So this paying slip is available in each and every bank, and we have to fill this paying slip beforehand, and then only we can deposit the money or check in the bank. So it is an evidence which says this thing, that a certain amount of money has been deposited either in cash or through check by the depositor. Check. Another documentary evidence, that is check. Check, it is issued by the bank. The check forms are being issued by the bank, and the drawer who is preparing that check, the account holder who has got an account in a particular bank, he is preparing the check under the name of certain party, and he is mentioning the amount there, ki that what amount is payable on demand. So he will sign that check, it will be countersigned by the drawer, okay, and then it will be given to the party, and then the party will go and deposit that check in the bank. And when the party will go and deposit the check in the bank, the amount will be debited from the account of the holder, that is the account holder who has drawn that check in favor of third party. So check is also an evidence which prove this thing, that the drawer has given a certain amount of money to a concerned party on whose name that check is being drawn. Then comes debit note. Debit note, it is that document which shows this thing, that the concerned person account is debited. The concerned person, that means the person on whose name this note is prepared, his account is being debited by a certain amount of rupees. Okay. It is prepared in the case, for an example, if the seller has sold the goods but he has charged lesser price of those goods, so then he will prepare the debit note in the name of that party to whom he has sold the goods, and he will write the difference amount there, and this will be an evidence that a certain amount of money as a difference in the rate will be paid by the concerned person whose name that debit note is being prepared. Then comes credit note. Credit note, it is evidencing that a concerned person on whose name this note is prepared, his account is credited with certain amount of money. His account is credited with certain amount of money. So this will be in the case when you have overcharged the invoice. Okay, when you have overcharged the invoice, and again you are doing the thing that you are now crediting the amount of difference in favor of that party from whom you have overcharged the money. So that difference amount which you have overcharged from them, by that amount you will be preparing the credit note on the name of that party, and which gives an evidence that you are supposed to pay that much amount of money to that concerned party on whose name you have prepared a credit note. So these were some of the examples of the source documents which are being prepared in the different conditions, and these documents are an evidence that the various types of business transactions have taken place or various types of transactions have taken place between the two parties. Hope these source documents are clear to you and you will be able to make the use of these documents while preparing the books of accounts in the proper manner. Thank you and have a nice day.